हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर नंद कुमार रावबावले फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग अंबाजोगाई इज गोइंग टू डील विथ इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स। दिस इज आवर फिफ्थ लेक्चर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मीनिंग ऑफ मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ ट्रेडमार्क, then importance of trademark, characteristics of trademark, scope of trademark, functions of trademark, evolution of concept of trademark, objectives of trademark act, salient features of trademark act. Today we will be discussing about registrar and register of trademark, grounds for refusal of registration of trademark, procedure for registration of trademark in detail. Every trademark which a proprietor wants to use it has to be registered with proper procedure of registration. Therefore, a special officer is appointed known as a registrar, and this registration is made in the register of trademark. It is the book where the trademark is registered. The appointment of registrar and other officials are governed by section 3 of Trademark Act 1999. The Controller General appoints a person to be known as Controller General of Patents, Design and Trademarks by giving the notification in Official Gazette. He is going to publish notification in Official Gazette regarding the appointment of Controller General for Patent, Design and Trademark. This section also provides the appointment of other staff required in the registration process of trademark. Also, it clarifies the powers and functions of the staff which is appointed under the Trademark Act 1999 Section 3. Coming to the functions of registrar, registrar has to classify goods and services, because the trademark which are to be given for goods and trademark are different. So these two different trademarks have to be registered, and it is the duty of registrar to classify the goods and services. Then second, registrar has to publish the alphabetical index of registered trademarks. So this index of registered trademarks helps the new person who is going to register his trademark, so that he can identify already registered trademarks, so that he can make changes in his trademark which is to be registered. To register trademark, this is another duty of registrar. He has to register the trademarks which are applied for registration by looking into the details whether these trademarks are valid or not, and registrable or not. To take cognizance of violence of trademarks, say for example somebody is misusing the trademark or infringement takes place, then a registrar has to take a cognizance of such violations. Then registrar has to consider application for registration. If a new proprietor applies for the registration of a trademark, then he has to consider his application for registration of a new trademark. To issue certificate of registration, on satisfaction of all conditions, registrar has to register the trademark and then he has to issue the registration certificate, just like a passing certificate for degree. Similar to that, he is going to issue the certificate of registration to settle disputes relating to registration. So always there are disputes regarding registration of trademark. So these disputes are like some of the people ask for registration of exactly similar trademarks which are already registered. Then disputes are going to arise, and such disputes have to be resolved by registrar to cancel the registration. On certain grounds, a registrar has powers to cancel the registration if he finds that there is a similarity between already registered trademark and newly registered trademark. Then he can cancel the newly registered trademark registration. Or else sometimes if the renewal is not made by the owner of trademark, then such registrations are cancelled. Whenever the term expires, a owner of trademark has to re-register his trademark, and if he does not re-register, then registrar has to cancel this registration. Registrar have powers of civil court, is not having powers of criminal court. Then registrar of trademark according to section 5. Register of trademark according to section 5. What is this register? Register of trademark is kept at the office of registration. So wherever there is an office of registration of trademark, this register is kept. Controller General specifies head office and branch offices of trademark. The head office of trademark is at Mumbai and branch offices are at Ahmedabad, Kolkata, Chennai and Delhi. So this register is nothing but a register where all details of registered trademarks are entered. An entries in register of trademark. The register shall contain entries such as what this register contains: name of trademark owner, then address of trademark owner proprietor, then description of trademark, what kind of trademark it is, explanation about the trademark, use of trademark, for what purpose this trademark is going to be used, and registrar controls and management of trademark. So registrar has power to control. So these are the entries: name of owner, address of proprietor, description of trademark, then use of trademark have to be entered into the register of trademark, and registrar has the powers to control and manage the trademark. Classification of goods and services in register. So the service marks and trademarks must be separately registered. So for service mark and trademark, we cannot register same trademark. Say for example, Jio is service provider, and another if we say Tata is a business organization. So then the Tata has to register another trademark and Jio has to register some other trademark. So these are the two different categories where service marks and trademarks cannot be same. So according to sections 7 and 8 of the Act, it compels a registrar to classify goods and services. So it is going to force registrar, it compels registrar to categorize goods and services in accordance with international classification. So there are international treaties, according to those treaties registrar has to classify goods and services. He cannot classify according to his wish, but he has to classify the trademarks for registration as a goods trademark as well as service trademarks, and that too depending on the international classification. Then coming to the grounds for refusal of registration of trademark, in which circumstances a registrar can cancel the registration of trademark. Every trademark is not registrable. Anybody can have his trademark and he will go for registration. Then registrar has to check whether the trademark which is applied for registration is registrable or not. Then trademark must fulfill essential conditions. There are essential conditions. What conditions it has to fulfill, that we will see in detail. Then trademark has to fulfill essential conditions. And duty of registrar is to examine application following the following conditions. There should not be absolute ground for refusal. If there is absolute ground for refusal, then he shall not register. There should not be relative ground for refusal. So ground, absolute ground should not be there, relative ground for refusal should not be there. And limitations as to colors, if it is subjected to limitations of color, then also that trademark cannot be registered by trademark registrar. So what are these grounds for refusal of registration of a trademark? That we'll see in detail next slide. So absolute grounds for refusal of registration according to section 9. If trademark is not capable of distinguishing goods, so this is nothing but if same kind of product is manufactured by two different manufacturers and the trademark of these two different manufacturers are very similar and the trademarks are not capable of distinguishing the manufacturer, then such trademark is of deceptive nature and is not capable of distinguishing goods, and a new trademark out of them, say for example two trademarks are there for registration, and one which is recent will not be allowed to register. So for example, we have Parle as well as Britannia. They have different trademarks. And if these two are similar, if they produce similar trademark, Britannia is old company or old manufacturer and he has got, it has got one trademark. And if Parle is also going to register same trademark, then Parle will not be allowed to register the similar trademark as that of registered by Britannia. It is of deceptive nature. If trademark is of deceptive nature means it should not confuse or deceive the customers. So customers should be capable of identifying the product which he wants to purchase or procure. Say for example, we have two products, Samsung and Samsung. So spelling mistakes, very minor spelling difference is there, and these two spelling mistakes may deceive the customers. Customers may not identify exactly from which manufacturer he wants to purchase. So such kind of minor difference, trademarks with minor difference cannot be registered. And third one is if trademark contains matter affecting religious faith. If a trademark on registration affects religious faith, then such trademarks cannot be registered. If it contains scandalous or obscene matter, if it is capable of creating some violence, such trademarks are not registrable. If registration is prohibited under emblem and names Act 1950, certain emblems and names are prohibited under Registration Act, and those emblems and names are not allowed to register. So these are the absolute grounds for refusal of registration. This act contains names and emblems of national interest. There are some names and emblems which are of national interest and are not allowed to be registered. Say for example, somebody wants to register national flag as his trademark, then national flag is not allowed to be registered as a trademark. Somebody if wants to register Ashok Chakra cannot be registered as a trademark. So such prohibitions are given on registration of trademark. Now, relative grounds. What are the relative grounds for refusal of registration, which is given in section 11? If trademark is likely to cause confusion in the mind of public, as it may have association with earlier registered trademark. So earlier, one of the company has registered its trademark and new company wants to register a trademark which is very similar to the earlier registered trademark. Then the people will be in confusion, thinking that this newly registered trademark company is having association with earlier registered company, and therefore which causes confusion among the people or society. So such trademarks are not allowed to register. So these are the relative grounds. If earlier registered trademark is well known in India, say for example, and latter trademark is likely to take unfair advantage in the sense, if a newly registered company or trademark owner wants to take advantage or misuse, wants to sell his product under the fame or name of a earlier registered trademark, then such trademarks are not allowed to register. Then if its use in India is liable to be prevented by virtue of law of passing of protecting the unregistered trademark, if it is prohibited in India, then such trademarks cannot be registered. As per the law, if any of the trademark is restricted from registration, any of the symbol, then such trademark cannot be registered or permitted. The name of chemical. International non-proprietary names are not registrable. Example, TRI, WHO are not registrable. Then the name and representation of living person or dead person, unless their consent is taken. Without consent, you cannot register name of a person, whether he is living or dead. So there must be a consent, and on consent, he can allow others to register his name as a trademark. Then see, limitations as to color. A trademark may be registered either subject to limitations as to certain color. So some of the trademarks are registered only specifying the color. Say for example, this is the trademark and we want to register it in this color only. So others can register same trademark with different color. So it is restricted to the red color only. If it is registered without limitations as to color, then nobody can register similar trademark in different colors. If it is registered without limitations as to color, then it will be registered for all colors. So it can be registered for any of the color. Procedure for registration of trademark. Section 18 to 24 specifies the procedure for registration of trademark. So who can register the trademark? Any person claiming to be a proprietor of trademark used. Sometimes trademark is already used and then he wants to register it or propose to be used. For example, somebody designs and wants to that trademark for his business, can register. Or somebody is already using one kind of trademark, then also he can register his trademark. By him can apply for registration of trademark. So any person already is using a trademark or wants to use or propose to use that trademark can apply for registration of trademark. The application may be made in the name of an individual. A person can make this application in his name or partner of a firm or a corporation, any governmental department, a trust or joint application can be made for registration of trademark. Very first, the application for registration of a trademark according to section 18 can be made. Every person who is interested to register a trademark has to apply for registration of trademark in a specified format. So format is prescribed, and that is known as a TM1. And a person who wants to apply for registration of trademark has to pay the fees of ₹2,500 for one class. So there are different classes, then he has to pay the amount as per number of classes for which he wants to register the trademark. A single form can be used. So a trademark owner need not to purchase multiple forms if he wants to register multiple trademarks for different classes. But fees shall be paid. He has to pay fees for each of the class. The same fees will not be applicable for all classes. So depending on number of classes, he has to pay the fees. Place for application. So where to give the application, where to submit the application? Every application for registration shall be filled in Office of Trademark within whose territory. So that is to be filled in the territory, means in the jurisdiction of that office, the principal office or places of business is situated. So one has to submit the application for registration of trademark at the main office or in the territory of that office, or else where that person is carrying his business. So in that locality, wherever is the office for registration of trademark or sub office, there he has to apply for registration. The Office of Controller General of Patents, Designs and Trademark is appropriate office for filing the trademark application in India. So it has got main office at Mumbai and branch offices at Delhi, Chennai, Ahmedabad and Kolkata. Preliminary advice and search. So before going for registration, a trademark owner who wants to register his trademark has to search for already registered trademarks. For that, he can get the advice from a registrar of trademark. Before or after applying for registration, the applicant may apply for a report as to whether the mark or one similar to it has already been registered or applied. So he can collect the information that which kind of trademark is registered, whether the similar trademark is registered or not. If not, he can apply for registration. He may also request for the registrar's opinion. A trademark owner who wants to register his trademark can take the opinion from registrar, but that opinion is not binding on him. The distinctive character of mark. Then registrar search report or opinion is not, however, binding on the trademark owner. Just he can seek for his advice, but that advice is not binding over the trademark registration or trademark owner. Acceptance of application. Section 19 says, on receipt of application, once you submit the application, registrar has to accept or reject. Registrar may accept or reject the application depending on. Registrar will cause the application to be examined. What he has to do? Registrar has to examine the application in regarding with whether it is registrable or not, or it is similar to the already registered trademark. Then he has to communicate. Registrar has to communicate to applicant any objection to the trademark. If anybody takes objection regarding the registration of trademark, then registrar shall communicate to the applicant. Then related to distinctive character and similarity. So if anybody is going to object or objection is made related to distinctive character or similarity of trademark with already registered, then such information will be given to the applicant by registrar. If he accepts the application, will be advertised in trademark journal. So once this application is accepted by registrar, then registrar has to give publication or publicity to that application in the trademark journal, so that all people, those who have registered, should know, should see the trademark which is going to be registered, and if they have any objection, they can submit the objection. If he refuses, if the registrar of trademark refuses the application, then he has to give the reasons why he has rejected the application for registration of a trademark. Then advertisement of application. Section 20 says that on accepting the application shall be published, application shall be published by registrar. It shall be published in trademark journal only, not in any other journal. The application has to be published in the trademark journal. The purpose of publication is to invite any objection. If anybody is having objection for registration of trademark, can give the objection in writing to the registrar of trademark. A person whose trademark rights may be suffered can object. Then a objection time limit is of 3 months from date of publication of that application in the trademark journal. Now, opposition to the registration. Section 21 gives opposition, regarding opposition to the registration. Any person interested can give notice in writing to registrar with the objections. If anybody is having objection for registration of a new trademark by any applicant, then such person has to give notice in writing to the registrar, and he shall pay prescribed fees along with the notice. He has to pay the fees. It is not free of cost. Registrar shall send notice to applicant. So then registrar has to send notice to the applicant, and applicant must submit counter statement within 2 months. Applicant has to justify that his trademark is not similar to the already registered trademark, or he has to clarify about the objections, that the objections are not valid. If he fails to do so, if the applicant fails to give the statement or counter statement, it may amount to withdrawal of application. Then it is assumed that the applicant has withdrawn his application. After consideration of objection, oppositions and counter statement, evidences submitted by parties, the registrar shall decide registrability of trademark. So registrar has to hear both the parties, applicant as well as the objections, and then depending on the evidences submitted by party, both parties, registrar has to take decision that whether the trademark is registrable or not. If it is registrable, then he shall proceed for registration, and if it is not registrable, then registrar has to refuse for registration. Then registration. Section 23 says about registration. After accepting the application and disposal of objections, the registrar shall, what he has to do, register such trademark with effect from date of application. So whenever you have submitted, from that date only your trademark is going to get a registration. After registration, registrar shall issue certificate of registration to the applicant, and if applicant fails to complete the process within 12 months, the process of registration shall be abandoned. It will be stopped. Effect of registration. After registration, what kind of protection is given? It is a prima facie evidence of its validity. It is first evidence for protection of that trademark. It does not confer any new right on the owner. It facilitates a remedy which may be enforced. So remedy in the sense, say for example, you have registered a trademark and somebody is going to copy your trademark, then you can take action, legal action against such person, and then such registered trademark gets protection, and that protection is enforced by law. Then trademark exists separately of registration. That means if you have a trademark and if you have not registered, then the trademark which is not registered shall not be protected. But if you have registered trademark, then it is protected. That means only having the trademark is not sufficient, its registration is necessary. Then it merely offers further protection under the Act. So only if it is registered, then only it is protected. Duration, renewal and removal of registration. So duration of registration. When trademark is registered, it shall be valid for 10 years from the date of registration. Then after that, the trademark which is registered already after 10 years has to be re-registered. That is nothing but renewal of trademark registration has to be made after 10 years by paying fees of renewal. Then removal of trademark. If owner of trademark fails to renew after 10 years, then such trademarks will be removed from registration by giving a notice in writing to the owner of trademark. And if this trademark is removed from register of registration, then also if applicant makes the application for restoration of the trademark with the prescribed fees within 6 months from removal, then it can be restored once again as a trademark or registered trademark. The only thing is the applicant has to submit within 6 months. After 6 months, restoration is not permitted. So this is how we have discussed about the process of registration of trademark, registrar and register of trademark. So I hope you have followed the details of trademark registration and register, as well as powers of registrar.